I'm going to talk about Darwin Park and the history. Examining plants collected by Sir Hans in Jamaica more than 3,000 years ago is extraordinarily powerful and provocative. These specimens are virtually unique from a historical point of view. Adventure. Living on the edge, it's rarely comfortable out in the field, so far from home comfort. Sometimes just staying alive is the challenge. And collecting insects. Different insects require different collecting methods. And some can be caught in the net, others in a cup attracted by rotting meat, and some are drawn to a powerful height. The plants it collects in the rainforest. Cicadas, long pruners, pressers, newspaper, and satellite phone.
Okay, now I'm going to talk about the Blue Zone of History Natural Museum. This part includes four sections. The first, human biology. Second, dinosaurs. After animals. And the last part is a part of Darwinism and human evolution. In human biology, you have different sections like grow up, cells, moving, optic visions, and in these sections there is funny information that is very adapted for child. The part of dinosaurs, you can find skeletons, real fossils, and artificial copies well done that look real. This part normally is the most visited for the child and includes a moving replica of a Rex dinosaur that is very amazing. The part of animals, you can find reptiles, amphibians, mammals, there are marine mammals, and marine invertebrates. And it's the same, you can find real fossils, copies, artificial copies, skeletons, and a little information about these animals. And the last part explains the human evolution, and there is a funny activity that there is a mirror when you have to make face of primates, monkeys face, and in the other part of the mirror it's you can see the other people making the jokes face, and it's so funny.